Now I am going to narrate a story. The subject of the story is the greatness of the association with pure devotees. The story was told by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to Sanatana Goswami while discussing the Atmarama verse. From this story, one can understand the importance of associating with pure devotees. Now we shall go to the story itself. CC Madhya 24.230. Once upon a time, the great saint Narada, after visiting Lord Narayana in the Vaikunthas, went to Prayaga to bathe at the confluence of three rivers, the Ganges, Yamuna, and Saraswati. Narada Muni is a great saint, is capable of traveling anywhere, both in the spiritual world and the material world. Once he went to Prayaga to take bath at the confluence of three rivers. You can see the confluence of three rivers at Prayaga. CC Madhya 24.231. Narada Muni saw that a deer was lying on the path through the forest and it was pierced by an arrow. It had broken legs and was twitching due to much pain. Narada Muni was passing through the forest and saw a deer lying half dead. It was suffering in great pain. CC Madhya 24.232. Further ahead, Narada Muni saw a boar pierced by an arrow. Its legs were also broken and it was twisting in pain. Boar was also suffering in great pain. CC Madhya 24.233. When he went further, he saw a rabbit that was also suffering. Narada Muni was greatly pained at heart to see the living entity suffer so. When he saw a rabbit suffering in great pain, Narada Muni was very much disturbed to see the animal suffering. The devotees of the Lord are very compassionate and don't like to see others suffering. Here you can see Narada Muni walking through the forest. CC Madhya 24.234. When Narada Muni advanced further, he saw a hunter behind a tree. The hunter was holding arrows and he was ready to kill more animals. CC Madhya 24.235. The hunter's body was brackish. He had reddish eyes and he appeared fierce. It was as if the superintendent of death, Yamaraj, were standing there with a bow and arrows in his hand. Actually, the hunter had a fierce appearance. CC Madhya 24.236. When Narada Muni left the forest path and went to the hunter, all the animals immediately saw him and fled. The hunter was standing behind a tree, but Narada Muni was walking through the forest and can be seen. So as soon as the animals which were supposed to be shot by the hunter saw Narada Muni, they ran away. CC Madhya 24.237. When all the animals fled, the hunter wanted to chastise Narada with abusive language, but due to Narada's presence, he could not utter anything abusive. CC Madhya 24.238. The hunter addressed Narada Muni, "O Goswami, O great saintly person, why have you left the general path through the forest to come to me? Simply by seeing you, all the animals I was hunting have now fled." The hunter can understand that Narada Muni was a great saintly personality. CC Madhya 24.239. Narada Muni replied, "Leaving the path, I have come to you to settle a doubt that is in my mind." CC Madhya 24.240. "I was wondering whether all the boars and other animals that are half killed belong to you." The hunter replied, "Yes, what you are saying is so." CC Madhya 24.241. Narada Muni then inquired, "Why did you not kill the animals completely?" Why did you half kill them by piercing their bodies with arrows? CC Madhya 24.242. The hunter replied, My dear saintly person, my name is Bhrigari, enemy of animals. My father taught me to kill them in that way. CC Madhya 24.243. When I see half killed animals suffer, I feel great pleasure. Bhrigari was a very cruel person. He was happy to see the animals suffering in pain. CC Madhya 24.244. Narada Muni then told the hunter, I have one thing to beg of you. The hunter replied, You may take whatever animals or anything else you would like. CC Madhya 24.245. I have many skins. If you would like them, I shall give you either a deer skin or a tiger skin. CC Madhya 24.246. Narada Muni said, I do not want any of the skins. I am asking only one thing from you in charity. Narada Muni is a great devotee of the Lord. He does not need anything from anybody. If he wants anything, he can get it by his own power. CC Madhya 24.247. I beg you that from this day on, you will kill animals completely and not leave them half dead. CC Madhya 24.248. The hunter replied, My dear sir, what are you asking of me? What is wrong with the animals lying there half killed? Will you please explain this to me? CC Madhya 24.249. Narada Muni replied, If you leave the animals half dead, you are purposefully giving them pain. Therefore, you will have to suffer in retaliation. When we give pain to someone, we also suffer the reactions. Here you can see Narada Muni speaking to the hunter. CC Madhya 24.250. Narada Muni continued, My dear hunter, your business is killing animals. That is a slight offense on your part. But when you consciously give them unnecessary pain by leaving them half dead, you incur very great sins. Killing animals is sinful, but leaving them half dead is more sinful. CC Madhya 24.251. Narada Muni continued, All the animals that you have killed and given unnecessary pain will kill you one after the other in your next life and in life after life. For every action in this life, we have to undergo reactions in the next life. If we are involved in sinful activities in this life, we have to suffer in next life. CC Madhya 24.252. In this way, through the association of great sage Narada Muni, the hunter was a little convinced of his sinful activity. He therefore became somewhat afraid due to his offenses. The hunter Bhrigari became afraid after hearing the words from Narada Muni. CC Madhya 24.253. The hunter then admitted that he was convinced of his sinful activity and he said, I have been taught this business from my very childhood. Now I am wondering how I can become freed from these unlimited volumes of sinful activity. CC Madhya 24.254. The hunter continued, My dear sir, please tell me how I can be relieved from the reactions of my sinful life. Now I fully surrender unto you and fall down at your lotus feet. Please deliver me from sinful reactions. He completely surrendered to Narada Muni and submissively asked from him the solution. This is a qualification of a bona fide disciple. How to surrender to a spiritual master is also explained in Bhagavad Gita. Bhagavad Gita 4.34. Just try to learn the truth by approaching a spiritual master. Inquire from him submissively and render service unto him. The self-realized souls can impart knowledge unto you because they have seen the truth. CC Madhya 24.245. Narada Muni assured the hunter, If you listen to my instructions, I shall find the way you can be liberated. Narada Muni is a bona fide spiritual master. Bhrigari is a bona fide disciple. Picture of Narada Muni. श्रीमद्या 24.256 द हंटर देन सेड माय डियर सर व्हाट एवर यू से आई शैल डू नारद इमीडिएटली ऑर्डर्ड हिम फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल ब्रेक योर बो देन आई शैल टेल यू व्हाट इज टू बी डन श्रीमद्या 24.257 द हंटर रिप्लाइड इफ आई ब्रेक माय बो हाउ शैल आई मेंटेन माय सेल्फ नारद मुनि रिप्लाइड डू नॉट वरी आई शैल सप्लाई ऑल योर फूड एवरी डे Srimadya 24.258. Being thus assured by the great sage Narada Muni, the hunter broke his bow, immediately fell down at the saint's lotus feet, and fully surrendered. After this, Narada Muni raised him with his hand and gave him instructions for spiritual advancement. Srimadya 259. Narada Muni then advised the hunter, return home and distribute whatever riches you have to the pure Brahmanas who know the absolute truth. After you have distributed all your riches to the Brahmanas, you and your wife should leave home, each of you taking only one cloth to wear. Srimadya 24.260. Narada Muni continued, leave your home and go to the river. There you should construct a small cottage, and in front of the cottage you should grow a tulsi plant on a raised platform. Srimadya 24.261. After planting the tulsi tree before your house, to daily circumambulate the tulsi plant, serve her by giving her water and other things, and continuously chant the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. Tulsi is a great devotee of the Lord. That is why every day in our temples we do tulsi arati and circumambulate the tulsi plant. Srimadya 24.262. Narada Muni continued, every day I shall send sufficient food to you both. You can take as much food as you want. Srimadya 24.263. The three animals that were half killed were brought to their consciousness by the sage Narada Muni. Indeed, the animals got up and swiftly fled. Narada Muni is a very powerful personality. He was able to cure all the three half-killed animals. Srimadya 24.264. When the hunter saw the half-killed animals flee, he was certainly struck with wonder. He then offered his respectful obeisances to the sage Narada and returned home. After this incident, the hunter developed more respect for Narada Muni. Srimadya 24.265. After all this, Narada Muni went to his destination. After the hunter returned home, he exactly followed the instructions of his spiritual master Narada. To make advancement in spiritual life, we have to follow the instructions of the spiritual master, just like the hunter. Srimadya 24.266. The news that the hunter had become a Vaishnava spread all over the village. Indeed, all the villagers bought arms and presented them to the Vaishnava who had formerly been a hunter. The hunter became a devotee. Srimadya 24.267. In one day, enough food was bought for 10 or 20 people, but the hunter and his wife would accept only as much as they could eat. Srimadya 24.268. One day, while speaking to his friend Parvata Muni, Narada Muni requested him to go with him to see his disciple, the hunter. Srimadya 24.269. As the saintly sages approached the hunter's place, the hunter could see them from a distance. Srimadya 24.270. With great alacrity, the hunter began to run towards his spiritual master, but he could not fall down and offer obeisances because the ants were running hither and thither around his feet. Now the cruel hunter had become very saintly by practicing devotional service. He does not even want to kill the ants. Srimadya 24.271. Seeing the ants, the hunter whisked them away with a piece of cloth. After thus clearing the ants from the ground, he fell down flat to offer his obeisances. Here you can see the hunter offering obeisances to Narada Muni and Parvata Muni. Srimadya 24.272, Narada Muni said, "My dear hunter, such behavior is not at all astonishing. A man in devotional service is automatically non-violent. He is the best of gentlemen." Srimadya 24.273, "O hunter, good qualities like non-violence which you have developed are not very astonishing. For those engaged in Lord's devotional service are never inclined to give pain to others because of envy." A devotee of the Lord develops all good qualities. This is also explained here. Srimad Bhagavatam 5.8.12, "All the demigods and their exalted qualities such as religion, knowledge and renunciation become manifest in the body of one who has developed unalloyed devotion for the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Vasudeva. On the other hand, a person devoid of devotional service and engaged in material activities has no good qualities. Even if he is adept at the practice of mystic yoga or the honest endeavor of maintaining his family and relatives, he must be driven by his own mental speculation and must engage in the service of the Lord's external energy. How can there be any good qualities in such a man?" Srimadya 24.274, "The hunter then received the two great sages in the courtyard of his house. He spread out a straw mat for them to sit upon and with great devotion he begged them to sit down." Here you can see the hunter receiving Narada Muni at his house. Srimadya 24.275, "He then fetched water and washed the sages' feet with great devotion. Then both husband and wife drank that water and sprinkled it on their heads." This is how we have to receive great personality like Narada Muni and Parvata Muni. Srimadya 24.276, "When the hunter chanted the Hare Krishna Mahamantra before his spiritual master, his body trembled and tears welled up in his eyes. Filled with ecstatic love, he raised his hands and began to dance, waving his garments up and down." Srimadya 24.277, "When Parvata Muni saw the ecstatic loving symptoms of the hunter, he told Narada, 'Certainly you are a touchstone.'" Srimadya 24.278, Parvata Muni continued, "My dear Narada Muni, you are glorified as the sage among the demigods. By your mercy, even a low-born person like this hunter can immediately become attached to Lord Krishna." Srimadya 24.279, Narada Muni then asked the hunter, "My dear Vaishnava, do you have some income for your maintenance?" The hunter replied, "My dear spiritual master, whoever who gives me something when he comes to see me." Srimadya 24.280, the former hunter said, "Please do not send so much grain. Only send me what is sufficient for two people, no more." Srimadya 24.282, "Thus I have narrated the incident of the hunter. By hearing this narration, one can understand the influence of association with devotees." Thus the hunter became a great devotee by the association of Narada Muni. His association was only for a short time, but still Narada Muni was able to convert the hunter to a great devotee. By this we can understand that even a moment's association with the pure devotee of the Lord is very precious. This is also explained in Srimad Bhagavatam. Srimad Bhagavatam 1.18.13, "The value of a moment's association with the devotee of the Lord cannot even be compared to the attainment of heavenly planets or liberation from matter, and what to speak of worldly benedictions in the form of material prosperity, which are for those who are meant for death." Srimad Bhagavatam 1.15, "Vasudha, are those great sages who have completely taken shelter of the lotus feet of the Lord can at once sanctify those who come in touch with them, whereas the water of the Ganges can sanctify only after prolonged use." Srimad Bhagavatam 11.2.30, "Therefore, O completely sinless ones, I ask you to kindly tell me what the supreme good is. After all, even half moment's association with pure devotees within the world of birth and death is priceless treasure for any man." In this, I would like to end the story. Thank you.